Denver 8 TV, your city, your source.
Dtown rocks, and we're here to prove it. Yes, Denver has one of the most unique theaters in the world, Red Rocks Amphitheatre, and here we are on stage. We're going to give you the full experience, a backstage tour, and we're even going to meet up with Colorado's own Big Head Todd and the Monsters as they get ready for a concert. How cool is that? And even though all of that is really amazing, there's still so much more to do, like
hiking and biking trails, history and geology at the Visitor Center, the Performers Hall of Fame, Shiprock Grill, The Trading Post, the brand new Colorado Music Hall of Fame, fitness programs, and going to a concert.
So, are you ready to start our 8 awesome adventures at Red Rocks? Well, almost. Now, you remember our I Love Dtown contest where a winner gets to come along on an awesome Dtown adventure? Guess what? Our lucky winner's here today to go backstage with us. You know, when we do a contest, we do it right. We love you, Dtown. So let's check this place out.
Long before there was an amphitheater, there were the Red Rocks, spectacular formations against the majestic Rocky Mountains. The area was once known as Garden of the Angels and Garden of the Titans. Not hard to see why. Today, Red Rocks Park is one of Denver's beautiful mountain parks with some great recreation, hiking, and biking trails. The Trading Post Trail is 1.4 miles in length and winds through some amazing scenery, valleys, and a natural meadow. The Red Rocks Trail is a 6-mile loop which starts at the lower north lot. It's a multi-use trail for hiking, horseback riding, and mountain biking. There's also a geologic overlook trail in the northwest part of the park. If you want to use these great trails, be sure to be safe. You can get more information online, and you can read the signs, because being safe is way more fun than being hurt. Red Rocks is a geological phenomenon, the only naturally occurring, acoustically perfect amphitheater in the world. The rocks that make up the natural amphitheater are named Creation Rock on the north and Shiprock on the south. Both of these monoliths are taller than Niagara Falls. Okay, time for a Dtown quiz. What kind of rock are the magnificent Red Rocks made of? Sandstone, limestone, or mud rock? The answer, I'll let you think, it's sandstone. Millions and even billions of years worth of geology, history, and music are showcased at the Red Rocks Visitor Center. Okay, well, maybe not millions of years worth of musical history, but many years worth anyway. At this beautiful 30,000 square foot visitor center, you can learn about the fascinating geology of the area. You can also learn about the history of the park and amphitheater, including the construction by the Civilian Conservation Corps during the Great Depression, and about the very first concerts at Red Rocks when it was still in its natural state. Plus, there's the Hall of Fame, which highlights concerts all the way to the present, with memorabilia, displays, and a timeline of all the concerts at Red Rocks through the years. More about that later. There are also some awesome exhibits to explore at the cool interactive hall. And if all the exhibits and other fun things to do at Red Rocks make you hungry, how about a meal at the unique Shiprock Grill? The restaurant is built around those two massive boulders, both inside and on the patio at the Red Rocks Visitor Center. It's open for lunch daily. On concert nights, make a reservation for a pre-show dinner to complete an unforgettable evening. It's quiz time. What is Colorado's official state fossil? Stegosaurus, Tyrannosaurus Rex, or Velociraptor? The answer? Our official state fossil is the Stegosaurus.
Now, did I mention that we scored a behind-the-scenes tour of Red Rocks with Big Head Todd and the Monsters? Well, we did, but first, it's time for our I Love Dtown contest winner. Drum roll, please. It's Mitch Chu, and here she is.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Mitch.
You had me.
We are so happy to have you. How does it feel to be at Red Rocks, Mitch?
It's amazing. We're going to get to see a lot and do a lot. I'm so excited.
Are you ready to get this started?
Let's go.
Here we go.
First, we met up with Jorgie from the management team at Red Rocks, who gave us a private backstage tour. This is where the artists and crews enter.
As you know, these buildings were built by the CCC in the late 30s, and you know, the amphitheater actually opened in 41. So we try to brighten things up as we come in, and on your left is mostly landscapes, and some of those people have submitted to us. Some of our in-house photographers have taken some of those. We try to showcase acts that have been here. So we'll have, as we go through the backstage area, you'll see that we try to get people that have played here a nice picture of them.
You've got pretty much everybody, it seems.
Yep, we do. Makes them feel comfortable when they come in. It's a point of interest. So as we come into the turn here to start going upstairs, we decided that we needed something to say, you know, to the acts, welcome to Red Rocks. And so we said the biggest rocks in rock and roll. Last year was the anniversary of the Beatles playing here, their 50th anniversary. They played here in August of 64. So we were looking for something unique to put up. And we found this online, this crowd shot. We have this ticket here that we decided to put up just because tickets no longer $6.60.
Oh, those were the days.
As all tickets say, it's a, you know, rain or shine like event.
Next, it was up the big hallway, full of pictures of all the current acts. So yes, it is the backstage tour. But the way Red Rocks is designed, we're also under the seats and the stage of the amphitheater. Next up, we got to see the dressing rooms of the stars.
Whoa, this is cool. You know, you can't help but notice the rock in the middle of the room. I mean, this is incredible. How did it get in here? What is it? That's real, right?
That's real. So when the CCC built this in 1941, they wanted to incorporate as many of the natural features as possible. An interesting fact is that during World War II, this was considered a place to go as a bomb shelter for the west side of Denver out here. It was designated as a bomb shelter.
Multi-purpose.
Exactly.
But also beautiful. You get some Red Rocks up close and personal before you perform for Red Rocks.
We try to make it as comfortable as possible for, you know, our touring artists. Lots of these artists have been on the road, you know, sometimes for months and months and months at a time. And this is, you know, where they come to, you know, relax a little bit and get ready, you know, for the performance.
Take a nap on this nice couch. Mm-hmm. So what do they ask for? What's kind of the most requested item that the artists might ask for?
Real thick, you know, nice fluffy towels.
Ah. Now the pictures continue on the way to
catering.
Uh-huh.
This was, we won the award in 2013 for the worldwide ticket sales in the top 100 amphitheaters. With 590,700 tickets.
Red Rocks on top, where we should be.
More cool posters, more awards.
This is where the stagehands eat, city employees, obviously the artists and their crews. Probably one of the most important things here is the ice cream cooler.
And the Don't miss that ice cream cooler.
And the snow cone machine, two very important aspects.
We were getting hungry as we checked out the spread. Then it was on to the production office, where the tour managers set up for the day of the concert. We caught up with Jeff from Big Head Todd and the Monsters.
1990, I moved to Boulder, Colorado from Pennsylvania. And my first two roommates ended up being the drummer and the guitar player for this band.
Really?
So I needed a place to live and they needed a roommate. And 3 months later, I was sleeping in the back of a van, driving across the country from Chicago one direction and San Fran the other. My favorite musical memory is probably when we learned that we were going to be able to be on tour and opening, supporting Robert Plant. Like, we heard that and we thought, it doesn't get any better than that. Robert Plant, to me, he's like, I grew up listening to Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
He is the voice of rock and roll. When he walked into our dressing room to say, do you guys have any extra tea? Can we get a spot of tea for our guys? We were flabbergasted and we were speechless because Robert Plant with his, you know, locks.
That's right.
Just walked into our dressing room. We thought, you're Robert Plant, but we tried to be cool. That was probably the greatest 3 week stretch of my life on the road.
Then it was back with Jorgie to continue our tour.
There's so much history here. You have to have a way to keep track of it all.
What we decided to do was make these plaques that commemorated starting in 1908 with the artists and the support artists in many cases that play here. And as we advance down the hall, you'll see that here we had 1908 to 1950 on one plaque.
Wow.
And the last plaque we did had 116 shows on it, I believe, from last year. So.
Wow. Let's take a walk, shall we mention,
all right.
Jorgie? Let's see. So it started in 1908, Feast of Lanterns, September 5th.
Yep.
And every year you kind of have a different combination of acts, but still some really, I see Nat King Cole there.
As the national, you know, acts come through, you'll see them, you know, looking for their names,
that's
you know,
right.
back a few years. And
all right, we're getting into the 90s now. Oh, I just saw Big Head Todd and Monsters played May 13th.
There you go.
1994. I mean, look at how many people have come here and different types of acts too, like you said, comedians, musicians. And we end 2014, because we haven't finished 2015 yet, with 116 shows.
Right.
Can you believe that?
And we're at the end of our wall, so I'm not sure what we're going to do for next year.
You got to build another wall.
Next, Jorgie took us through the tunnel, which goes under the seats of the amphitheater, heading up to where the audio for the shows are mixed.
Wow, look at this.
And as you can see, the artists from the very beginning have, you know, started signing their names here, and there's names over names.
Wow, this is really a living history of every person who's ever been here, it seems. Look at all of these signatures on top of signatures. Oh, I just saw Big Head Todd and the Monsters, no kidding.
There you go.
Right there.
That is.
I might have to ask you permission to put Dtown on here. What do you think?
Yeah, we could probably do that.
I might be able to make that happen. All right, up we go. You run these stairs?
Yeah, always, because it's good exercise.
Oh my gosh. I don't think I have it in me.
Well, I'm always in a hurry, so. John Mayer.
They even come down here and do the edge of the stairs,
yep.
too. Wow. Oh, this is a nice little set aside from the rest.
Uh-huh.
Nice. Well, you aren't kidding. The signatures continue in here onto the pipes.
Yep, everywhere.
Oh. All right, Jorgie, tell us about where we are right now.
So right now, we're just behind the front of the house mix area. And this is the area where the Denver Film Society, about 10 times a year, puts on the program called Film on the Rocks. So Film on the Rocks features, you know, local comedians and musicians, and then, you know, popular films.
And so this is where they actually show them, right up mm-hmm. in this area. This is like yep. the control hub almost.
Exactly.
Another chronological history. This one is of all the films over the years for Film on the Rocks. We got to glimpse the sound and lighting checks.
That's loud.
Thanks, Jorgie and Jeff. Stay tuned for more behind the scenes at Red Rocks, and we'll meet Big Head Todd and the Monsters. Plus, much more of our 8 great things at Red Rocks when we come back. One fun adventure at Red Rocks, shopping. You can start at the very cool trading post. Even the building itself is fun. Historically, it was known as the Red Rocks Pueblo for its southwestern design. The trading post is located on the south side of Red Rocks before you get to the amphitheater. The structure was designed by W.R. Roche and has a breathtaking view of the valley and rock formations to the south. Trading Post is a great place to shop for unique Red Rocks souvenirs. You can browse the large selection of outerwear and historical memorabilia, including park and amphitheater history books. The Trading Post is open daily from 9 o'clock to 4 o'clock. The Trading Post is also the perfect place to start a walking tour of the park. The 1.4-mile Trading Post Trail offers some spectacular views. For more shopping, you can also visit the merchandise counter inside the visitor center for a variety of goods, including t-shirts, hats, and rain gear, to postcards, trail maps, and memorabilia. Sweet! Quiz time! What year was the Trading Post constructed? 1912, 1931, or 1957? The answer, this very cool building has been around since 1931. That's 10 years before the amphitheater was completed. Brand new to Red Rocks is the Colorado Music Hall of Fame, located at the Trading Post. This Hall of Fame honors the artists and individuals who have made outstanding contributions and defined the state's amazing and diverse musical legacy. The Hall of Fame preserves historical artifacts through displays and interactive elements in a dynamic environment. Among the exhibits and first inductees is John Denver. The exhibit includes a personalized tour jacket and stage outfit, his custom guitar and custom-made guitar straps, gold and platinum record awards, sheet music, magazine covers and tour programs, handwritten lyrics from his personal notebook, plus photos from his film and television career. Also at the exhibit, Judy Collins, Chris Daniels, Firefall, and Red Rocks Amphitheater itself. The amphitheater was also one of the original inductees into the Hall of Fame. Which one of the following are not inductees in the Colorado Music Hall of Fame? One Republic, Flash Cadillac, or the Serendipity Singers? The answer? The group not in the Colorado Music Hall of Fame is One Republic. Not yet, anyway. And now we continue our behind-the-scenes look at Red Rocks. Our I Love D-Town contest winner, Mitch, and I got to meet Big Head Todd and the Monsters.
So exciting.
All right, so Mitch, you're the biggest fan of all fans of Big Head Todd and the Monsters.
Yes.
What would you ask?
Who are some of the artists that you have played with that people don't know that you
played with? Well, our closet classic secret trump card is Robert Plant.
Yay!
That was one of the funniest summers that we spent, was touring with Robert.
What's your favorite or most memorable show you've seen at Red Rocks?
I saw the U2 Under a Blood Red Sky. Yeah, that was pretty awesome.
Everyone.
Yeah, but I was here.
Yeah, that's why.
I don't know if it's embarrassing. It's actually kind of cool. My mom was a huge Barry Manilow fan. And she brought me when I was 8 years old to see Barry Manilow at Red Rocks. That was my very first concert ever. And it was what it was, because she was having a great time. You know, she was in her late 20s or early 30s. And I didn't even know what to do, but that's my first concert, Barry Manilow.
My first Red Rocks experience was seeing the Doobie Brothers, I think, with their first farewell tour. And I was like 13.
Really?
And that was pretty mind-blowing. But the most memorable experience is the first time we got to play Red Rocks. Blues on the Rocks, 91. So that was impressive. And then Albert Collins asked Todd to come out and join him. So that's probably the most memorable Red Rocks experience I've
ever. Yeah, what were you thinking when he asked you to come?
I was just scared.
You're like, I don't know. All right, Rob, what's your favorite Red Rocks memory?
I've seen hundreds of shows here, so I've seen everybody. But my first one was George Thorogood, probably about 78 or something like that. So that was memorable. Just the first time you experience this is such a great place.
So what's your favorite thing about playing at Red Rocks?
Well, aside from the fact that it's the greatest venue on the planet, and it's our hometown.
I don't know, it's a good chance to show off in front of your friends, too, you know.
Yeah, it's a pretty good show off.
It is.
Hey guys, watch this.
Yeah, that gets you in trouble, though, that's the thing. You know,
for 8 or 10 hours, one day, I'm cool.
Yeah. See, you know, we all grew up in the metro area, so we grew up seeing shows here. So just having the opportunity to play Red Rocks every summer.
What's your favorite part of D-Town?
I think Denver is actually probably the hippest city, or one of them, in the country now. It's becoming hipper. I notice when we travel,
tell people that
we play with a lot of bands, and a lot of bands now are saying Denver's one of their better markets. And so I think there's a lot of younger people moving into town, and I'm glad to see it, because we grew up here, and it's nice to see Denver kind of, you know, flower into what I think it's going to become, which is a cultural center.
After hanging out with the guys, it was time for them to do a sound check. How awesome to be on stage with the band at Red Rocks.
Have you ever been way up top at Red Rocks? Now, all of the seats here are amazing, but thanks to the big screen, no matter where you sit, you can feel like you're right up on stage. And that's thanks to the Denver 8 TV crew, many of which are our very own D-Town crew members.
Well, this is my summertime job.
Pretty cool. Although I have to say, D-Town viewers will probably recognize you from the penguin shot that everyone got to see when we were at the zoo.
Well, that's right. I only shoot penguins and rock and roll stars.
Robin with Denver 8 TV, you're here working at Red Rocks. What's your main gig tonight?
Well, here close to the stage, we get the low angle shots, so we get the close-up shots of the performers and instruments and everything, and we also get crowd shots too.
Wow, so you really do have the best seat in the whole house.
Absolutely.
Katrina, one of the camera operators here for Denver ATV. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
What's it like to run the camera in a setting like Red Rocks?
It's a really amazing job, I have to tell you. I see really great music, and also, I mean, it's just a gorgeous place to be.
I'm jealous. You get to be here for your job.
Yeah, it's amazing, you know, and there's a really great crew that I work with as well. It's definitely a team effort. We couldn't do this, you know, without one another.
What's it like to shoot when the weather comes in? What do you do?
Yeah, well, we've had a lot of weather this year, so we just kind of cover up and, like, button down the hatches and just get after it. You know, it's part of the job is to be prepared for anything.
The show must go on.
The show must go on.
Yep, the concert's going on, rain or shine. Loyal fans arrive, ready for anything.
Good job! Rock it!
Yeah, yeah.
High five from Dtown! Rock it out! Good job!
The anticipation builds in the final moments before they take the stage.
Cool house lights, please. Thank you.
Comes together for the big screen, so it was on to the TV control room.
We're hanging out backstage at Red Rocks with David, the director. Look at what he's doing here. He's working. Let's see if we can talk a little bit.
Hi.
What are you doing, David?
I'm actually, we're putting shots together with using our four cameras. Our shots go out to the big LED screen in the audience, and it's basically for people that are up in the far rows, whatever. We try to bring them a seat like they're sitting in the first one or two rows.
You're pretty much creating the experience for them.
Yeah, the sequence of shots goes together. Let me start a song here.
Yeah.
Bridges all 1-1. The bass player started it. And we'll always keep our eyes on Todd, because he's like the guy.
Yeah, of course.
Made his name Big Head Todd of Monsters.
That's right, it makes sense.
Tune and back to tune. You see, he doesn't really have that big a head.
It's not what we were expecting, David.
Right. See this button right here?
Yes.
Put your finger right over it. When I say go, you hit that one right
there. Got it.
Go.
There you go. I just directed.
Right. You don't get any of my feet. That's good. You actually took a shot.
Thanks to Big Head Todd and the Monsters, our I Love Dtown contest winner Mitch, and everybody at Red Rocks for an unforgettable evening. Come for the view, stay for the endorphins. Yes, Red Rocks hosts some amazing unique workouts, and all fitness levels are welcome. Two special events include the Red Rocks Fitness Challenge and Yoga on the Rocks. The Fitness Challenge is a 12-week program that takes place at the amphitheater. The goal? To improve participants' health and wellness through education and inspiration. Yeah, it doesn't get much more inspiring than Red Rocks. A team of personal trainers and a lifestyle coach help participants with group training sessions and professional nutrition and lifestyle coaching.
Spread those feet, make this a challenge for yourself.
Then there's Yoga on the Rocks. Up to 2,000 yogis experience an exhilarating workout at, yes, one of the most awe-inspiring venues in the world. Yep, you can experience the rocks from the perspective of the downward facing dog. Red Rocks Amphitheatre has become a popular site for workouts. Please check out the website for rules exercising at Red Rocks. This is for the enjoyment of others and to prevent structural damage to this beautiful one-of-a-kind resource. Of course. So, which of these is not a yoga pose? Extended puppy, firefly, or leaping whale? The answer, well, at least as far as we know, there is no leaping whale pose. Who's your favorite performer? What was your favorite concert at Red Rocks? The Hall of Fame lets you experience the history and excitement of the performances here. From Springsteen and Jimmy Cliff to Santana. There's Buddy Guy, The Eurythmics, The Go-Go's, Ozzy Osbourne, Willie Nelson, Widespread Panic, and many more. Along with some awesome displays and a timeline of concerts, there are some very cool interactive exhibits showcasing past performances. In 2014, there were 116 shows here at Red Rocks. Yeah, I'm thinking these Red Rocks concerts might just catch on. The Hall of Fame is located in the Red Rocks Visitor Center. Nice. Okay, in which year did the Beatles first perform at Red Rocks? 1963, 1964, or 1965? The answer, it was their first year in the U.S., 1964.
All right, well, as you can see, Red Rocks is about concerts and so much more. Were you taking notes? No? No problem. Here's the recap.
Red Rocks Amphitheatre is one of the most stunning, unique concert venues in the world. It was once listed as among the 7 wonders of the world, and that's just the beginning of the fun here. Red Rocks Park is one of Denver's mountain parks and offers spectacular scenery, plus hiking and biking trails and recreation. For shopping, there's the historic trading post. For souvenirs, musical memorabilia, and much more, there's also shopping at the Red Rock Visitor Center. Also inside the Trading Post is the brand new Colorado Music Hall of Fame. Displays and interactive features help tell the story of our state's outstanding musical artists. John Denver, Judy Collins, and Red Rocks Amphitheatre are among the inductees. The Red Rocks Visitor Center features geology and history of this awe-inspiring area and the amphitheatre. There's also the Interactive Hall and a Hall of Fame, which showcases all of the artists who have played Red Rocks over the years. The Shiprock Grill is a great place to catch a meal, for lunch any day, or for a fabulous pre-concert meal with reservations. Red Rocks Fitness Challenge and Yoga on the Rocks are great, unique ways to get inspired to get in shape. And of course, you can attend a concert. We did, with Colorado's own Big Head Todd and the Monsters. Red Rocks Amphitheatre was opened in 1941, so 2016 marks its 75th anniversary. Happy anniversary, Red Rocks! We'll start celebrating now.
All right, we said it before, now we proved it. Dtown rocks. Get down here and enjoy. See you next time.